Welcome back to PCTV News. I'm Marquise Brown.
And I'm Ryan Johnson. This is our last news segment of the year.
The last segment of the year is presented by Forrest Boynton, and it's about the bond passing for the new school.
Let's watch it.
Well, our roles with the organization, I'm superintendent of schools, and
I'm Jay Harris, the executive director of operations for the school district.
So the bond issue that passed in April, the way this works, I'll kind of oversee it on a high level, but in terms of day-to-day construction, managing the construction team that we have in place, Dr. Harris will be in charge of that. I'll primarily oversee the financial side of the bond issue, make sure that things are running on budget and on time, along with managing the issuance of the general obligation bonds.
Good question. So we're going to start pretty quickly this summer. And so the first thing we're going to do is take out the baseball field. We have a lot of work to do with utility relocations and some major site work that will have to happen. But this summer, a lot of that real heavy utility relocation will happen so that we're not disrupting the school year next fall. The current building will remain in phase one, so it will not be taken down. It will stay right where it's at. That way students and staff can continue to be educated in their current environment while a new structure is being built out on the baseball field just behind the high school. And once that's built, we'll have a connection between the two, and we won't start doing anything with the current building until we get into future phases that would all have to be voter approved. About 26 classrooms. There will be several science labs. That's one of the major concerns with our current high school is the inadequacy of our current science labs. Project Lead the Way would also be a part of a classroom in phase one. And then a number of just standard learning environments that would impact every core area. So phase one is essentially 152,000 square feet. It would sit on, right where our current baseball field sits today. So our baseball field would have to be relocated. That would provide, again, 26 classrooms. It would provide a new gymnasium, an auxiliary gymnasium. It would provide a new wrestling room, weight room, new commons and cafeteria. So all students would have one area to eat breakfast and lunch. Also one kitchen, so we would become more efficient in our operations. And all that equates to 152,000 square feet. There's also some site improvements as well. Like I said, we have to rebuild our baseball field because that's the location we're building on, but also traffic flow patterns, bus traffic separated from vehicle traffic, and making sure we try to improve the overall traffic flow of the campus. So the parking lot, the site work that's going to expand the parking and also improve some of the traffic flow, part of that will happen in phase one, not all of it, because in the photo that you see that has the phasing of the project, it's still showing, it's showing that the current high school is taken down. Obviously the current high school is going to remain there. So there will be improved parking on the north side of the high school. But you'll still have the current building there, so it won't be the full parking lot until we start to demolish that portion in future phases. So phase one does not provide a new track. It does have a current improvements to our existing track, so it's going to be some patching and resealing. We do know that we have a need for a new track at some point in time. Our track is overdue. That's going to have to be completely taken out and replaced in a future phase. But in this particular phase, we are going to be patching it and providing a new seal over the surface.
that was really interesting. Wednesday, May 26th, is our last day of school. Have a good summer, Pirates.
Have a good